We're asked to interpret the y-intercepts of the equations that represent the change in house value for Hawaii and Mississippi. But for both equations, x equals the number of years since 1950, and y equals the median value of a house in the given state. Well, notice how both equations are in slope-intercept form, which is the form y equals mx plus b, where m is the slope and b is the y-intercept. So notice how for the equation for Hawaii, the y-intercept is 74,400. For Mississippi, the y-intercept is 25,200. In general, if we have an equation and want to find the y-intercept, we set x equal to 0 and solve for y. So if we didn't recognize these equations were in slope-intercept form, for example, for the equation for Hawaii, if we set x equal to 0, we'd have y equals 3,966 times 0 plus 74,400, which does give us 74,400. Now that we've found the y-intercepts, let's interpret the results. For Hawaii, again from the equation we know that b, the y-intercept, is equal to 74,400. This is a point on the y-axis though, so as an ordered pair, it would be 0, 74,400. And because x equals the number of years since 1950, and y equals the median value of a house in the given state, this ordered pair tells us in 1950, the median value of a house in Hawaii was $74,400. Let's write this as a sentence. Now let's consider Mississippi. We know the y-intercept B is equal to 25,200. As an ordered pair, this would be 0, 25,200. Which means in 1950, the median value of a house in Mississippi was $25,200. Let's also take a look at the graph of these two equations on the coordinate plane. These are the two points where the lines cross or intersect the y-axis. These two points are the y-intercepts. Let's look at a second example. We're asked to interpret the y-intercept of the equation that represents the change in the number of high school students who smoke out of every 100 students. For this equation, x equals the number of years since 2011, and y equals the number of high school smokers per 100 students. Again, notice how the equation is in slope-intercept form, and therefore the y-intercept is equal to 16. So because the y-intercept, or b, is equal to 16, we know this would be the ordered pair 0, 16. And once again, because x is the number of years since 2011, and y equals the number of high school smokers per 100 students, the y-intercept tells us in 2011, 16 out of every 100 high school students were smokers. Looking at the graph of the given equation, notice how here is the y-intercept, the point where the line crosses or intersects the y-axis. I hope you found this helpful.